Hello, my dear students. In this lecture, we are going to see one previous year gate numerical. This question was asked in gate 2016 for 1 mark in set 3. Basically, this question is based on conduction topic, that is conduction through a slab, composite slab. Let us understand the question. The question is, steady one-dimensional heat conduction takes place across the faces 1 and 3 of a composite slab consisting of slab A and slab B in perfect contact as shown in figure. Now, my dear students, here they have mentioned that in the first statement, they have mentioned it is a steady, right, and one-dimensional. Therefore, we will use the formulas of steady 1D heat transfer, right. Then, here from 1 to 3, the heat transfer takes place. Temperature at 1 is 130 degrees Celsius, temperature at 3 is 30 degrees Celsius. Therefore, heat always flows from high temperature to low temperature. Therefore, the direction of heat flow will be from 1 to 3 like this. This will be the direction of heat flow, right? And for this heat flow, the perpendicular area will be the here, this width marked with blue color. This width into this height, this will be the perpendicular area for the direction of heat flow, right? Let us again go back to the question. Where Ka, Kb denotes the respective thermal conductivities. Now here, for first slab or for first wall, the thermal conductivity is Ka, which is 20 watt per meter Kelvin. And for slab B, the thermal conductivity is 100 watt per meter Kelvin. Then, using the data as given in the figure, the interface temperature T2 in degree Celsius is. Now, with the help of all these dimensions, let us find this temperature T2. Now, my dear students, let us observe this case. Now, can I say the heat is flowing steadily, right? Means at each and every location, the heat transfer is same. Because of this word steady, right? As heat is flowing in one directional, therefore from 1 to 3, along x direction, heat is flowing, right? Here we can say this is a qx, heat transfer in x direction. And as the flow is steady, therefore the heat transfer at each and every location is same. That means we can say heat transfer in A through slab A is equal to through slab B is equal to Qx. Likewise, we can say. And my dear students, for the heat transfer, there will be a resistance in slab 1, that is slab A, as well as resistance in slab B, right? And for here, as it is a conduction heat transfer because it is through solid, the conduction resistance, R conduction, we know that is nothing but L divided by Ka, right? L divided by Ka, that formula we have derived for the conduction resistance, where L is nothing but length of that particular slab. Here length of A is 0.1 meter. So let us write them. Length of A is equal to 0.1 meter and length of B is given 0.3 meter. Right. Here L is length of slab, K is thermal conductivity of respective slab and A is the area of perpendicular to the direction of heat flow. That is here this height into width. Right. Now my dear students, here I will mark this area with some hatching. This is the area. This is a perpendicular area for the direction of heat flow. And for both slab, the area perpendicular to the direction of heat flow is same, right? And my dear students, here as the heat is flowing through slab A, there will be a conduction resistance in slab A that I will say RA. And this RA will be equal to LA divided by KA into area of A, right? As well as there will be a conduction resistance in slab B, which will be RB is equal to LB divided by KB into area, as area is same for the both slab, right? Therefore, if I draw a circuit, heat transfer circuit from 1 to 2, if the temperature drops from 1 to 2, the heat transfer resistance is LA divided by KA, that is RA. Therefore, from temperature T1, let us say temperature T1 to temperature T2, here temperature T2, the resistance is RA, which is nothing but LA divided by KA into area, right? And from T2 to T3, we can say from T2 to T3, the resistance is RB. From 2 to 3, resistance is RB, which is nothing but LB divided by KB area. Therefore, it is RB, which is nothing but LB divided by KB into area. Right. And my dear students, through this circuit, heat is flowing. Through this circuit, heat is flowing Q. Right. And my dear students, as it is steady state heat transfer, therefore, heat transfer, which is nothing but change in temperature divided by resistance, will be same in all the slabs, which I will write. If I write T1 minus T2, then I have to write RA, right? That is T1 minus T2 you have a resistance in slab A is equal to, if I write T2 minus T3, then I have to write resistance in slab B. And if I write T1 minus T3, that is complete temperature difference, then I have to write both resistance, that is RA plus RB, right? And they are in series, they will get added, right? Therefore, my dear students, here I will use first two equations to solve this question. To find interface temperature, we are writing the heat transfer between slab A is equal to heat transfer between slab B, right? So let us put the values. Therefore, we can say the Q is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by RA, which is equal to T2 minus T3 divided by RB. So let us put the values. So my dear students, this heat transfer Q is equal to T1 is nothing but 130 degrees Celsius minus T2 divided by RA is nothing but LA divided by thermal conductivity of A into area is equal to T2 minus T3 divided by, here resistance in B is LB divided by KB into area. So my dear students, let us put the values in this expression. Let us put the values and let us solve for T2, right? Now my dear students, if I put the values, let us put them here. T1 is given 130 degrees Celsius, right? So let us put here 130 degrees Celsius minus T2 need to be calculated divided by length of A is given 0.1, thermal conductivity of A is given 20, right? From both side area will get cancelled. Here from both side area will get cancelled. Therefore area will get cancelled. So let us put the values. LA is given 0.1 divided by KA is given 20 is equal to T2 minus T3 is given 30 degrees Celsius. Here you will find T3 is equal to 30 degrees Celsius, right? Here you can see 30 degrees Celsius. So let us put this T3, which is 30 degrees Celsius, divided by, here LB is 0.3, KB is 100. Let us put them. Therefore 0.3 divided by 100. Now my dear students, in this complete equation, can you say only T2 is unknown? So let us solve this school level mathematics. Let us find this T2. Now, as I have kept temperatures in degrees Celsius only, this T2 I will find in degrees Celsius only. Therefore, the T2, if I solve for this T2, I will get 67.5 degrees Celsius, right? So my dear students, here in this fill in the blanks, they are asking T2 in degrees Celsius. So let us write down 67.5, because already unit is mentioned. Therefore, if I write here 67.5, I will get full 2 marks or 1 mark, whatever may be the number of marks asked for this question, right? Thank you, dear students. In next lecture, we will see one more numerical on this topic, which was asked in previous year GATE examination.